Hi, this is Dr. Taryn P. Lupo, and today we're going to talk about polycystic ovary syndrome, or PCOS. Let's talk about polycystic ovary syndrome. To understand it, you first have to understand how ovaries are normally supposed to work. What happens is as you develop eggs, they actually come to the surface of the ovary via a cyst. So multiple cysts will develop at one time inside an ovary. The dominant cyst, or the one that grows the most, will actually be the one to pop and release an egg. All the rest of the cysts that develop kind of shrink back down and get reabsorbed into the ovary. During polycystic ovary syndrome, something goes wrong. Those cysts that are supposed to get reabsorbed don't. Although they don't release eggs, they still form all over the ovaries and you get multiple cysts. These cysts then go on to produce extra hormones that shouldn't be there. And this causes most of the symptomology of polycystic ovary syndrome. The ultimate reason this happens is actually kind of surprising. It's a sugar regulation problem. People who are insulin resistant or have insulin surges develop PCOS. Insulin resistance is kind of a fancy way of saying you're pre-diabetic or you're about to develop diabetes. You can no longer regulate blood sugar correctly. Most insulin resistance happens due to a lifetime of a bad diet. Things like eating too much meat, fat, oils, and especially refined carbohydrates can set this in motion. The insulin resistance actually wreaks havoc on your hormonal system, especially an enzyme called 1720 lyase. This will promote testosterone production where you shouldn't really be making it. This rise of testosterone is a problem, but what also happens are the cells on the ovaries, the thecal cells, they also produce too much estrogen too. This causes a weird mix of symptoms that present in PCOS patients. Sometimes they'll end up growing hair where they're not supposed to grow hair, or they'll get adult cystic acne. The other issues is they have real problems with carrying a baby. Infertility is the main reason PCOS is such a problem. Insulin resistance is the ultimate cause of all these problems. Not only that, but the surges in insulin and testosterone create a vicious negative feedback loop and will perpetuate the insulin resistance. It also causes thyroid problems. Later on, you can develop autoimmune thyroid problems with this condition. One of the sad things is some women spend fortunes trying to get pregnant and carry a baby and never have PCOS actually regulated or managed. This is the main reason women have infertility problems and they can't carry a child. Ultimately, it's because of their diet. PCOS is really affected by insulin surges, and you'll kind of see two presentations with this. You'll see people who are insulin resistant, and you'll see the other side of the coin, people who are hypoglycemic. And a good way to tell the difference is usually to look at the body. Most of the people who are insulin resistant have very stubborn weight they can't get rid of. On the other side of the coin, you'll see hypoglycemics who are usually skinny PCOSs and often misdiagnosed. Also, one last thing about PCOS, a lot of women get problems with their menstrual cycle. So they either have irregular periods, very long painful periods, or they don't even have periods at all when they get stressed out. So there are natural ways to manage this. This is really about controlling insulin resistance. You want to use the same diet a diabetic would use in order to reduce your acne, your facial hair, your infertility, and your menstrual problems. If you adopt that kind of diet where you reduce your meat, oil, especially your refined sugars, you'll see a vast improvement. Ultimately, a plant-based diet is going to be the best direction to go for this condition. So just stay on top of your diet if you want to manage your PCOS. Also, if you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up and share it out. I always appreciate that. Stick around and check out my next story on joint pain. We're going to talk about natural management of the inflammation of joint pain.